Oh, my goodness me. It is freezing out there. And that's officially put my workshop build on hold. The concrete's poured, the building's come along, and I'm now onto the roof. But with temperatures this low, I can't do much more just yet. So instead, I've retreated indoors, and I thought I'd use this as an opportunity to talk you through something that I've been wanting to cover for a while. Pause the video, get your hot chocolate or your mulled wine or your glue wine, and let's settle down for a nice warm chat. When people think about smart home tech, it's always the flashy gadgets that steal the show. The robot vacuums gliding around the floor, mops with a mind of their own, or the ever-growing screens of smart TVs. And yes, those are fun devices, but today I want to talk about some of the unsung heroes of the smart home world that are silently helping me in every video, but you just might not notice them as they're super small. Indeed, that's exactly what I want to cover today. How small can I make something? This is the wallet, but made extra, extra small. The nano wallet, or the walletette. This is actually way more than a wallet. It lets me pay for things, drive the car, open doors, carries ID, locates itself, locates my phone, lets other people report it stolen, and it's waterproof. It can control the lights and the heating when I come home and switch them off when I leave. And all of this is packed into just 5.87 millimeters of space. Let's get crafting, and I can show you some cool ways to make 3D prints look more stylish and share two cool bits of tech that have allowed this. The wallet is of unknown origin. We think it might be old French for knapsack or roll, and the purse is of more certain origin from Old English, meaning a little leather bag. Now, they're obviously shrunk over the years from bags to relatively small devices, but they're still a bit clunky. And the silly thing is, they often mean I need to carry a bag anyway, as you can't exactly easily slip them into your pocket or clothing without looking a little peculiar. So let's break down the bulk. Cash and coins is easy. The bank card has replaced all of those, so they're just redundant. Now I can use my phone, but sometimes I just want to leave that at home, like when I'm playing sports or when I'm going out for the evening. So I think 1 millimeter of card space does a lot. This also allows IDs and even modern car keys. So space for one or two cards solves a lot for very little space. A lot of the wallet is actually just padding and general options, trying to cater for everyone's possible needs. But this is the modern world. We can design exactly what we want. But house keys are where we need help. Flippin' heck, I've gone from being freezing to absolutely roasting, so I'm going to have to move over here, I think. Oh. Now, there's this little device that I want to build this concept around that can absolutely nail this. Switchbot have introduced their wallet finder card, which is what it does, but it does way more. In fact, I think it might be the missing piece in eradicating wallets completely. Let me tour you through what it does and why I think it might solve this. First off, it's a locator, just like an AirTag or any of the other many solutions out there. So this means that I can find my nano wallet if I lose it, and people can find me if I get lost. This locating is also handy, as it also can control your house. So when I get home, automatically turn on the lights, turn on the heating, and when I leave, do the opposite. Secondly, it has a neat button. So for me, clicking this button automatically locates my phone. Already, it's doing way more than a wallet ever could. But then, even more awesomely, it has an RFID tag built in. and you know how useful they are. If not, watch all my other videos. Suddenly, you can make any card, tag, or sticker open your door if you fancy. It also has loads of extra handy features like a QR locator on the back if lost, and an anti-tracking mode to alert you to unknown smart trackers nearby, which has been a common problem of AirTags. It's waterproof to IP67, but most importantly of all, it's thin. Seriously thin. Like less than a coin thin. But to understand why I'm excited about this, you have to pair it with another product, the Lock Pro. Now, this is the first smart lock I've seen that actually is ready to go. It's got SwitchBot's usual super compatibility with all the mad range of lock types in the world, so it's easy to install. You can just use it with your phone, and this lets you remotely lock and unlock, schedule and more. But when you start to integrate it with SwitchBot's other accessories, it just gets very cool indeed. The keypad touch adds PIN entry, fingerprint entry, and RFID entry to your options. So suddenly there are tons of cool ways that you can control your doors. So you can use your fingerprints to unlock the door, a code or any RFID sensor. So you can buy loads of cheap cards to just scan and add. So you could share a key for guests and enable it to only work for a set period of time. If you have a cleaner, let their key only unlock the house at certain times, or more regular visitors can have a fingerprint added. It's clearly pretty endless, but putting this together, it eradicates the need for keys. And if they don't do it in the colour that you want, don't worry. I've got 3D print files that I can share that will allow you to change it to whatever colour that you desire in seconds. And with these two devices, suddenly our bulky wallet has disappeared. And we can design something super thin to contain just the wallet finder and the cards I need. I'm going to make one for myself and one for my husband. Now, 3D prints can look a little utilitarian often, so let's see if we can style it up a bit. I'm using these awesome holographic beds from Bamboo Lab, which add cool effects to any prints that you produce. I like the carbon fibre look, but for this, I'm going to use the polygon-styled bed. For myself, I'm going with white and sparkly, of course. Now, this alone looks great already, but I want to add some details. So I have etched a bear for my husband and extruded a butterfly for myself, so I can cut out some inlays. This is obviously optional, but for those of you who've been messaging in excitement at the new M1 Ultras you've brought, congratulations, from my previous video, you can guess what I'm using for this. It's crafting time. And with that done, I give you the Nano Wallet. This is so gorgeous. I can do so much with such a tiny thing. And I can take it anywhere with me and it'll fit anywhere. I hate having a bag. I never go out with a bag. I just put this in my pocket and it doesn't matter how slinky my outfit is, it will just disappear into it. If you don't recognize this from another video, go and watch it. There's a story about this. I do want to thank SwitchBot for letting me show off this. I mean, I kind of said I was going to do it regardless and they had literally no say. Nor have they even had a chance to even see this video before you. But I'll thank them anyway because I do love their products and I use them everywhere. And so many of theirs are good examples of these really stealthy smart devices that you barely notice. So as I said at the start, look out for this sort of more subtle smart tech, as it can make an enormous difference. It might be a water leak detector that you really don't know is there until you suddenly do, and it saved you thousands. It might be the little switches that modernise old-fashioned tech to save you replacing things. I also use their little hub to modernise old devices like my TV mount. This completes a missing piece and lets me control the whole room to go to movie mode whenever I want. Or it might just be the sensors that sit outside and inside to let you trigger alerts or actions based on events. I just got nudged to turn off all the outside taps as the temperature has dropped to that dangerous freezing point where ice starts breaking everything and bursting pipes. So whilst you're looking at the big ticket items, excuse me, during Black Friday, why not have a look at some of those little devices too? I think they make really great little gifts for friends, family, or yourself. You've worked hard this year. I've worked hard this year. I deserve one. I think it's time to go. Catch you later, folks. Have a great weekend.